there's other items where we had jambalaya last night. That's one of the main dishes. And then what they call the king cake. And I think you may have seen the king cake out. And the king cake is basically also green, gold, and purple, where they have a little baby. If you all get the baby, you have to do the king cake. Another item that they do in second line, you may have seen this on TV a lot, is that they do what they call the second line dance. So there's history behind that. The first line in the past, it actually started off with funerals. So the first line was basically either the band or the family. They were so maybe more somber. And then the second line was the celebration of life. So as you know, we have had our family members that have passed, and we had a moment of silence that Jackie did for us last night. But even though they have passed, they want us to be happy, and they want us to be successful, and they want us to continue in life. And the second line is a celebration of that. So the committee is going to kick off the second line. We're going to kick it off, and we want all the family to join. So part of the second line, you'll see, if you see it on TV, you'll see the umbrellas. And it actually started off actually to protect you from the sun, and then it just grew from that. And then also on second line, you'll see the hankies. And you can do a scarf or anything that's white. You'll notice that we have our special hankies celebrating our 40th anniversary. So when we come through, we want you all to join in and celebrate with us as a family as we celebrate our 40th anniversary. So we'll go ahead and kick off the celebration, and we'll begin.
Thank you.
break.
Hands. Heavenly Father, we come to you this afternoon as humbly and as graciously as we know how. We're coming to you, Lord, to give you all the praise and all the glory for this great family that we have. We want to thank you, our Heavenly Father, for bringing us again, yet once again, for our 40th anniversary. Lord, we know all the praise, all the glory goes to you, and we want to just say thank you. Lord, we want to thank you for this food we're about to receive. Allow it to nourish our body. Give us strength. Give us health, and we're asking, Lord, that you put your loving arms around this family once again. Watch over us, guide us, and protect us. We're asking these and other blessings in your Son, Jesus' name. Amen.
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 Yeah, that's gonna be nine.
You know how to pick
your plate by yourself? You help? Awesome. You gotta fix your plate by yourself? Come on. Then why you gotta pay?
Pass your coat. You should come up there with this white on and say, I got your bag. It was good.
I told you, man, trying to work
too
bad. You don't work
with
him.
Can you roll it down?
Roll it down the line, man. Come on, man. Man, you don't work for nobody, man.
What did I tell you? I said, Devonna Regina has been waiting on them pancakes.
All day. I ain't even had no brothers. Or no sisters.
Now you're gonna eat a problem.
Come here, brother. Did you get your pork? Or back in the room? It's down here, sweetie.
I'll take a little bit.
What's main?
No, hey, before I got my hug, yeah.
I can't, I to the tree when I get done eating. I'll be back. I'll be back.
This can make you drink lemonade, drink.
I'll tell you this list.
Hello folks, how y'all doing tonight?
Hello.
Or today I should say. How are you enjoying the 40th family reunion? Eubanks family reunion.
It's good.
Mind introducing yourselves?
You're from Dallas, aren't you?
Yeah.
Okay, I thought.
And what's your name?
Thomas.
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 Hi, Thomas.
I'm Sadie.
Hi, Sadie.
I'm from Memphis, Tennessee.
Memphis. Memphis in a house.
Yes, granddaughter, Sadie Eubanks.
Sadie Eubanks, granddaughter.
And what's I'm Mary.
Mary.
Granddaughter of Sadie Eubanks. Cousin of Roy and Eubanks. We double cousins.
Ah. Thank you.
So that makes Mildred and all the others, so we all double him.
And who might
be Deshauna Williams, Thomas Williams, wife.
Hi.
Daughter-in-law, Sadie.
Pleased to meet you. Glad you guys can enjoy this festivity. How you doing? Larry, how you doing?
All right, all right.
How are you enjoying the 40th family reunion?
Bread, bread.
Take your time. Don't choke. What's one of your more special family reunions? How does this compare to the others?
Most of my family here this time. You talk about me not here and stuff like that. You're about all of them here. You know, except for kids. That's the only one that ain't here. And I think, I can hardly talk.
Oh no, take your time. Thank you. That's all I needed. Oh. You can thank God.
Her. Honey. We were in New York. I'm gonna tell this one, honey. No, she said share a special memory. And we were sitting at Mary's table.
You were in Milwaukee.
In Milwaukee. And we were sitting at Mary's table.
Look into the camera.
And we were sitting at Mary's table. And honey came through Mary's living room. And when she got in the kitchen, Vera told us, I thought there was a Mack truck coming through the city. And I expected honey to react differently. Honey just walked up to us, I love you too, Aunt Vera. That got away with her so bad.
Mary, can you share a special memory of
Mary? Well, I have one, but I don't think I can tell it.
Okay.
I can't put it on camera.
Uncle Arb, you have a special memory you want to share?
My baby, let me say, I'm in the middle of
somebody else. You want to share a special memory of Aunt Vera?
Yes, I do. She's a very outspoken, and she didn't care if she hurt your feelings or not.
Amen.
And she stayed on me. One thing she said about me, I wasn't allowed in New York. See, I had to lose 150 pounds before I got to New York.
Amen. She was honest.
Guess what? I ain't lost 150 pounds, so that's why I ain't been in New York.
That's good, honey. That's good.
This chapter is on the reflection of family members who are deceased, and this is presented at the 2012 Eubanks Family Reunion, which celebrates the 40th reunion. Corey, share a brief memory with one of your past family members that you'd like to share.
Well, the person I'm going to talk about is my Aunt Vera. I can remember growing up as a kid, about 6 or 7 years old. There was a friend of the family named Tad, I believe was his name. But anyway, he was a friend of the family, and for the longest time, I always thought Tad was Aunt Vera's husband. So as I was growing up and everything, I always be like, hey, you guys remember Aunt Vera's husband? And, you know, who's that guy, you know, Aunt Vera's husband, that guy right there. And everybody would be like, Aunt Vera's not married. I'd be like, oh yeah, Aunt Vera's married. She's married to that guy over there. And I was like, because every time he's around, Aunt Vera's real, real nice. You know, she's hugging on you, she's loving on you and everything. And I can remember, you know, as growing up as a kid, all the kids would go around the back. If Aunt Vera was in the front room, or whatever to avoid Aunt Vera. So one time I came in through the front, I didn't know Aunt Vera was up front, and she stopped me. I was like 6 or 7, and she picks me up and she's holding me in her arms like I'm a baby, holding my head up, you know, so my neck up so I can hold my head up, but I'm 6 or 7 years old. And I'm like, why is Aunt Vera being so nice to me? But then I looked over and there's who I thought was her husband. But now, lately I found out that that was just a friend of the family named Tad. So anyway, that's my reflection on Aunt Vera or whatever. And, you know, God rest her soul. I loved her. She was a great person. And that's pretty much all I have to say. Thank you.
Amen. Thank you.
Hi there, I'm Jackie, and I'm going to piggyback off of Corey's story. I'm going to have two short ones. I'm going to start with Aunt Vera, because like Corey mentioned, we did used to avoid Aunt Vera, because Aunt Vera used to force us to give her a hug and a kiss. And as kids, we weren't trying to hug or kiss. But we always knew there was one auntie that we would have to hug and kiss. But it's amazing how God works, because as I got older and became a woman, I learned to treasure those moments, those hugs and those kisses with one of my favorite aunts, and that's Aunt Vera. I truly miss Aunt Vera, although she's still with me in spirit, and I just want her soul to rest in peace and always have proud moments and memories of our Aunt Vera.
Amen.
Then I'm going to switch gears on you. I have a cousin, Yolanda Land Nidham. Back at the White House, many years ago, we were probably 11 and 8. And this is probably around a time in the summer, I'm gonna go with July, when it's real hot, therefore the grass is real dry. And Lynn and I are outside in front of the White House, just below the steps, and we're playing with sparkles. Got the sparkles lit, and we're twirling and twirling and twirling. And I'm not gonna say which one, but one of us dropped our sparkle on the ground, and the grass caught on fire. Now Tony, and I do believe it was Brad, were also outside, and they were playing catch. Now Lynn and I are panicking, because the grass is literally burning. And I remember calling out to my big brother, Tony, said, look, the grass is on fire. He turned around, looked, and turned right back around and continued to throw that ball to Brad. And I remember thinking, we're going to get killed for burning up this grass. And Big Daddy, being the Big Daddy that he is, just came out and was like, babies, don't worry about it. Put the fire out and assured us all was well, and it really was. Great memories with my family that has gone on to glory. Big Daddy, Lynn, Aunt Vera, Uncle William, Uncle Jim, Uncle Bobby, Cousin Stacy, Aunt Stella. 40 years of a tradition is awesome, but it's more of a thrill to know that though they are not with us in body, they're definitely with us in spirit.
Yeah. Thank you, Jackie. Yes.
I would like to say some of the fond memories that I had with Vera come and stand with me the night. She stayed with us quite a few times during the 90s. During the family reunion, and Mary would always call me, well, Vera's coming to town, J.E., so you got to go pick up at the airport. And I never forget this one year. I think it was like about 1999, and Vera was like laid off from a job. But anyway, she was going to stay almost 2 weeks. And that's when I began to say, 2 weeks with us? And the story goes, so she did. I picked her up maybe on a Thursday. We went through the family reunion that weekend, and then she got to be with us all next week. And I'm going to get you this. I was on vacation that week, and after my vacation, I was going to work the following week, that Monday, after about the 11th day maybe. And Vera was leaving that same day, going back to New York. So when I go to work, and when I come back home, they eat from work. I know Vera, someone has picked Vera up and took her to the airport. But as I opened the door and walked to my front door, as soon as I walked in the door, I heard somebody say, hi, John. And I just said, oh, Lord, what is this? But it really was great having Vera around us all the time. We really enjoyed it. My sister was a very wonderful person.
Oh, yeah.
Cared about everybody, wanted the best for everybody. And, you know, I really miss her dearly.
Yeah. She's here in spirit.
Yeah.
Thanks for sharing your reflection.
She would come in, you know, she'd come in, and when she would first get in town, first thing she would say, hello, Mildred. is my room ready? And she said, the queen is here. And I really
that's
miss
a good,
her.
That's a good beer.
I like that. I really miss her. Yeah. Thanks.
Well, thank you. Anything in reference to a past family member that you'd like to reflect on for the 40th Eubanks family reunion?
Yes, I would like to pay tribute to my aunt Vera, and I never had the opportunity to tell her, but if she's listening, which I'm sure she's with us today in spirit, that I really appreciate her. As a young child, I was scared to death of you. Thought she was the meanest auntie in the world. But as I got older, I learned to respect your opinion and appreciate you as an individual. And when I went to New York, I regret not having the opportunity to visit you, because that would have been my last chance to actually see you. And that really broke my heart. So I didn't have the chance to say it then, but I'm saying it now, that I love you, auntie. And I hope that you watch over us and guide us whenever you get the opportunity. And keep on flying with your wings, you'll stop around your neck.
Thank you very much.
Yeah!
we need. Oh, it's cool, right? Wait, y'all picked a good spot.
That's what I'm saying. Stay out of the sun.
Yeah, come on.
Okay. Right. Do you want?
Are we doing rings?
No, we're doing a semi-circle like this. Yeah, this is fine. So people can see. Ready?
No.
Okay.
Oh. That's number
that's
number two.
We got more than 40 balloons. Okay. So, Jackie had did this last night. We did a moment. We did a moment of silence for our family that passed. We just a moment of silence. This is for Aunt Stella. This is for Uncle Jim. This is for Aunt Vera. We all a fantastic family. Don't worry about the balloons. We got more than 40 balloons. We're just doing this as a symbol of 40 years and 40 years to come. We had the first generation that took us to about 20 to 30 family reunions. The second generation and the third generation is already stepping up and taking the second generation place just like it's supposed to be. Yeah. So on the count of three, we're going to release the balloons and then we're going to go in and do We Are Family. And we're going to get in there and clean up because Corey's already given us notice. We got to get out by 7 o'clock. Okay. So one, two, three. Yay! Yeah.
So we green? We green too?
That's okay. Watch the
of course, you guys will look and make sure we get high. All
right, get that.
Just keep your eyes open, they all fly. Just like me.
Yes, just like me. Who that leader right there?
Dude, I'm thinking we're gonna go.